And by the way, where were all these people screaming about privacy invasion when Tiger Woods' personal life was coming apart? I don't remember one civil libertarian or one civil libertarian group sticking up for this guy's right to have privacy in his humiliating personal life falling apart. And look, I'm not gonna lie, I enjoyed reading Tiger's text messages as much as anybody. They were fucking fantastic. But I don't mind enjoying that because I don't pretend that I'm any better than him. I admit publicly, you bet I'm a piece of shit, and I'm a much better dirty texter than that idiot was. He just wasn't very good at it, because you know what I mean? He would just kind of copy and write things he heard in porno. It was really awful. Like, but they, by the way, they didn't even show what the girl said. They would only show you what Tiger said. Dirty text messages, even in context, are very damaging. But out of context, they look really, really bad. And he sent her one, he goes, "I want to choke you and slap you in the face." That looks bad. Especially with no context. You don't know what the girl said to inspire that. It could have been anything. "I'm gonna commit genocide." "Oh, I'm gonna choke you and slap you in the face." Well, who knows, maybe she was a horrible racist. "You got pretty good for a jigaboo." "I'm gonna choke you and slap you in the face." Or maybe it wasn't even Tiger. Maybe he put his phone down at a party and Ben Roethlisberger picked it up. But I have to, it's okay to enjoy that stuff as long as we stick up for people when they're thrown under the bus for behaving like we do. Because again, it was really funny to watch such a nice looking guy be so completely filthy. And I am a pervert for real. And some of his text messages made me go, "Oh, Jesus." Like he wrote one, he goes, "I want to fuck you in the ass and then shove my cock down your throat." You might want to put LOL after that. Or at least reverse the order. Nobody minds if you shove your cock down their throat and then fuck them in the ass. That's just the common way of saying, "Hey, thanks for a great evening." But if you write, "I want to fuck you in the ass," your next text better be, "And then I'm going to hop in the shower immediately and scrub my dick with lava soap. And then you can suck it if it doesn't stink any longer." I don't remember a whole lot of privacy advocates standing up for Mel Gibson's right to fall apart in his personal life in private. Where were all the advocates when his voicemails and these conversations were played on Entertainment Tonight and all over the 6 o'clock news? Not one person said, "This is disgusting, we shouldn't watch this." And boy, did I love listening to those. I have them on a loop in my iPod. But I don't pretend that I've never spoke. I love what these fucking, every guy on TV is just, what a fucking bunch of phonies, these sportscasters and newscasters and pundits on Fox and CNN. They're all like, "Oh, I've never spoken to a lady like that before." Wow, I guess you've never had a relationship. That's every argument I've ever been in. They were just sexual things. We've all had a relationship fall apart and you start arguing about the sex. And these things were hilarious. Like at one point she goes, "I don't know what's the matter with you." And he goes, "You were supposed to suck my dick before the jacuzzi." And people were like, "He's crazy." Is he? A promise is a promise. Obviously, a discussion had taken place. They were going in the jacuzzi. She was gonna suck his dick first. That sounds fair. I don't have a jacuzzi, but if I ever get one, you will absolutely have to suck my dick before you set foot in it. I'll either tell you or you can read the sign that's posted. Now, I don't know what happened. I don't know why she didn't suck his dick, but I think if men are being honest and not sanctimonious, Very few things are as enraging as a promised blowjob not delivered. We don't want to hear your excuses. We have no empathy. What do you mean, death in the family? Wasn't you? So what are you saying? Your mouth and tear ducts don't work at the same time? Why don't we 69? You can blow me and cry on my balls. That would feel fantastic. Mel Gibson is hilarious. Everything he said belongs on a hat or a coffee mug or in a book of morning affirmations. One beautiful quote after another, and the biggest one, the most famous quote, she's like, I don't know what you want me to do. And he goes, why don't you smile and fucking blow me? I got a chill when I heard that. That's right up there with one small step for man. Was anybody surprised, by the way, that Arnold Schwarzenegger cheated on his wife? No, I think we were surprised at his choice. Well, I guess Arnold wanted to fuck the bassist from Van Halen. What a fat monster that maid was. What, did he met her on the set of Total Recall when her head was coming apart in the airport? 2 weeks, 2 weeks. Jesus, be more selective. What, did he pull his penis out in the kitchen? First woman that walks by is getting this stuck in her dumper. You fatty with the dish towel, get over here. And I'll bet you that Arnold, because he's such a dominant alpha male, is probably a big submissive sexually, and because that maid had to hustle for everything in her life, she probably just read him better than his own wife did. Like, every girl that lays there probably bores him and just says stupid shit like, oh, terminate me, oh. And meanwhile, the maid threw him on the floor, stuck her feet in his mouth. Your movies are terrible. You sound like a retard when you talk. And Maria Shriver, by the way, is too skinny. What does she weigh, 110 pounds? Arnold's a big guy. He probably got tired of climbing on and jamming it in and her going, And then he got that fucking wildebeest in the sack. He couldn't hurt her pussy if he hit it with an anvil.